Everyone and their mother is talking about bulletproof coffee these days, it seems. It is the recent trend in keto diet, it is all around Instagram, lots of recipes and supposed health benefits from it. Are they right? Is it as great as they say it is? Is it safe? Is it for everyone? Keep watching, the answers might surprise you, because you know us in this channel, we will put our science glasses, our laboratory coat, and we'll examine it right now, pulling apart facts from fiction. My name is Tasos Koidis, lecturer of food science and nutrition here at Queen's University Belfast, speaking about our everyday foods, health tips and tricks. If these topics are interesting for you, it would mean the world to me if you would like this video, subscribe to this channel to spread the message across. What is bulletproof coffee? And let's begin on how to make it. Bulletproof coffee is a high-calorie, caffeinated drink made with added fat, mostly butter and coconut oil. You're supposed to drink it just as this coffee here, in the morning and head to work or go about your day. Good but not bulletproof. The original recipe calls for good quality coffee coming from good quality grounded coffee beans, unsalted grass-fed butter and some medium-chain triglycerides, is MCT, just as some of them that are found in butter or coconut oil. We will come back to what is MCT in a second, but as far as the drink, the ingredients are blended together, served warm, and they take a look of a creamy latte, essentially. It is like a latte, well, until you take the first sip, and when you take it, oh boy, does that taste different. How different from milky coffee? Well, I mean, quite different. Peculiar, strong, fatty, like a blob of fat that fills your mouth. It's an acquired taste, to say the least. But again, it really depends on how much added fat you put in. Did you see that there was a wide range in the recipe? You can max it out to 4 tablespoons. That is 2 from butter, let's say, and 2 from MCT. It's another oil we will explain. But this equals to an epic 60 grams of fat in one go. Now that's a mouthful of 540 calories right there. Because at the lower rate, say 20 grams of fat, I mean, it's not that different from a full fat latte, at least in taste. Because in fat and in calories, yeah, I mean, there's a big difference to begin with. Now, what is MCT and how different it is from, say, coconut oil? As we said, MCT stands for medium chain triglycerides. Triglycerides are fat molecules. They have a backbone, which is called glycerol, and they have 3 slots, 1, 2, 3, for 3 fatty acids. The fatty acids are carbon chain molecules that can be either saturated, no double bonds within the atoms, or unsaturated, 1 or more double bonds within these carbon atoms. Oleic acid is a long chain fatty acid because it has these 18 atoms. So the corresponding triglyceride, oleic, is a long chain triglyceride. Many of our standard cooking oils, like olive oil, sunflower oil, are quite rich in these long chain triglycerides. So here the recipe calls for medium chain triglycerides. These are the smaller ones, fatty acids, from C16 to C12. Caproic, caprylic, capric acid, and lauric acid. If you want to get MCT naturally from whole foods, coconut oil has only 55% MCTs. Palm kernel oil, 54, but it's quite rare to find it. Whole milk, 9%, and butter, 8%. So you see now why most people use butter and coconut oil to get their MCT. Now, if you want to go all in, you want to use an oil that has 100% MCT in your recipe. But you can't find that in nature, so you must turn to science, to us, let's say, to make it. But not to worry, because it's not taxing or complicated process. We only do what is called fractionization of either palm kernel or coconut oil naturally to get a mixture of C8 and C10. Here is a bottle that I have in my house. MCT oil is metabolized by the liver, and almost like all other fats, it is absorbed by the body, supplying a ready source of energy. It seems that MCT is absorbed a little bit faster than other oils in the body, but this is to be confirmed because we need validation of these findings. What happens to my cereals and my carbohydrate-rich breakfast? What are the benefits? Most of us are accustomed to carb-heavy breakfast, cereals, cornflakes, oats or bread, jams, croissants, donuts. But those spike blood sugar levels and leave us craving for another sugar fix by mid-morning. With Bulletproof Coffee, you are getting on average 250 calories, which on its own is not that much, but if you are getting good quality fats, namely butter and partially coconut or MCT, because they are good, that arguably fills you up more, suppresses your appetite, and does not mess up with your sugar levels in your blood. But remember, this is not a Bulletproof Coffee only invention. This doesn't happen only with Bulletproof Coffee, because we see the same effects with a high-fat breakfast, high-protein, high-fat breakfast. Wondering ever why the typical builder's breakfast is eggs and bacon? High-fat, low-carbohydrate. Keeps you going until lunchtime or more. Do not have bread for a day if you can. Limit your rice, your potatoes, your pasta. One fruit a day if you can help it. Your diet will be naturally high in fat, naturally high in protein. But you will feel fuller. You will not have the appetite to overconsume, because even if fat is high in calories, the rest of the foods you are eating, and most importantly, the foods that you are not eating, helps you with satiety. So, a high-fat diet, especially in the morning, quenches appetite, stabilizes hunger, and provides calories to fuel your morning. And that's okay. If you can take that to the extreme, you cut your carbs completely, well, I mean, that's a keto diet. That's a different story. Bulletproof Coffee fits the ketogenic style of eating because it contains no carbs and the body converts the MCT oil to ketones for energy in the absence of carbs. That is only for the people who are following a keto diet. And don't forget the coffee itself, because it provides alertness, improves short-term memory recall and reaction time, and increases your resting metabolic rate, which is your baseline calories. All of these are due to caffeine. See here in the video I have on the health benefits of coffee, and I have an interesting take on that video, so make sure you look at it. Why you must be a bit cautious? Which are the negatives? I think the main one is that if Bulletproof Coffee is your only breakfast, you are missing out on the opportunity to eat a nutrient-dense meal. In its place, you are consuming one thing, a high-fat, satiating drink, but lacks valuable nutrients. I mean, the elephant in the room is that the fact that you are consuming a lot of saturated fat, because the fats included in Bulletproof Coffee are very, very high in saturated fat. Butter plus coconut or MCT will shoot your daily intake to 20 grams of just saturates, when the recommendation is 20 grams for the whole day. You haven't even started eating properly, you know, meat, dairy, vegetables later in the day. All of this will add up to your total daily saturated intake. The high saturated fat in Bulletproof Coffee can be problematic for individuals with a history of heart disease. That's evident. The current advice for those with cholesterol problems is to avoid high levels of saturated fat, including butter, in the diet. So saturated fats way above the health guidelines. Unless we want to say that the guidelines, with all of their flaws that come with generalization, are useless, and you know, and we can discard 50 years of nutritional science in the trash. I mean, getting a bit controversial, but that's the opinion of some people out there. And yes, I know, although there is new evidence to suggest that low-carb, high-fat diets don't necessarily increase your blood fat levels, it is worth proceeding with caution on this one. This is because actually we don't know the long-term effects of this way of eating. It is unknown. Yes, temporarily you will initially notice good results, maybe some improvements in the cardiovascular factors, obesity, type 2 diabetes, high LDL cholesterol. However, these effects are thought to be limited over time if you continue eating like that. Also, there are some implications for the caffeine in the morning, caffeine intake, triggering stress, hormonal imbalance, sleep disturbance, but that's not really what the video is about. I think we can bypass that quickly, especially if you can have a decent decaf coffee these days. A bulletproof decaf coffee, right? Quick truths and myths about Bulletproof Coffee. Gives you energy boost? True. Increases alertness and mental clarity? Myth. There have been a few studies specifically looking at the effects of bulletproof coffee. One 2021 study found this type of coffee was no better than black coffee in improving cognitive performance. Benefits were seen in the feeling of fullness, increased feelings of satiety, and reduced expectations of food after 3 hours. And that's good. That's what we talked about, right? Next thing, drink it early in the morning. Myth. As with regular coffee, it is better to wait a couple of hours after you wake up for your natural hormones to kick in, your cortisol specifically, to kick in before you actually supply your body with caffeine. This will take you longer in the morning and it will prevent this midday dip related to caffeine that you might have experienced as well. Final thoughts. As you see, a lot of what we have just said is about coffee itself and not specifically about bulletproof coffee. Although bulletproof coffee may prevent hunger, support energy, and be a weight loss alternative to a carb-rich breakfast, there is not enough evidence to confirm all the above. So, as far as we scientists know, as far as we think, we don't have enough studies to prove those three claims. Really? Is that the best we can do? Okay, yeah, I know. Let me have another go. Even though black coffee is very good for you on moderate consumption, adding large amounts of saturated fat to your coffee is, number one, not a long-term solution for long-term health. Number two, not for everyone, really depending on the blood cholesterol levels of these people. And this is down to the saturated fat intake, even if it's coming from MCT or other natural sources like coconut and butter. Really, that is the most important, saturated fat intake. So, is bulletproof coffee the magic bullet? Of course not. Eggs do the same, if you ask me. High protein, high fat, better, more graciously, more elegantly, more naturally, and allow me, maybe with a better taste. It is a trend, guys. And as all trends, it will come and go. And as always, it is important to listen to your body and consult with a healthcare professional before making any major dietary changes. Check at these videos to learn more about cooking oils and fats, omega-3 sources also. For coffee, its health benefits, caffeinated versus decaf, I have a great playlist over here just for you. And that's about it for today, folks. Thank you very much for watching until the end and see you in the next video. Bye!